Hello viewers, I welcome you on the lecture series of Corporate Accounting, and under today's discussion we are taking up unit 1 of the Corporate Accounting, where we are going to discuss in detail about issue of debentures. Issue of debentures, when we talk about, it's a mode of taking loan, that means a form of taking loan from the persons concerned, or it is known as acknowledgement of the loan to the company. So, under issue of debentures, under today's lecture, our objective is to learn in detail about meaning and purpose of issuing debentures, what are the various types of debentures, identifying the ways of issuing debentures, understanding the terms of issue of debentures. So, these are the four criteria which we are going to learn in detail one by one. We will learn about debentures in the light of the provisions which are being given under Companies Act 1956 also. So, first of all, let us understand what do we mean by debentures. Its other name is loan capital, because it's a source of fund to the company where debentures are being issued and loan is taken from the company, for which the company is going to pay a fixed charge to the debenture holders. It's different from the shareholders, because equity shareholders and preference shareholders are being given the dividend, while the debenture holders are being paid interest. And such interest is to be paid whether the company is earning profits or not, while dividends are subject to the availability of the profits. So, debenture or the loan capital is different from that of the source of capital which is arising out of the issue of shares. So, today we will learn how debenture is being defined and what are the various types of debentures. First, a debenture is a unit of loan amount. When a company intends to raise the loan amount from the public, it issues debenture. A person holding debenture or debentures is called debenture holder. A debenture is a document issued under the seal of company. So, again, elaborating this definition or meaning of debenture, we can say that where a company's intention is to take a loan, and such loan is not taken from any financial institution or banking sector, but it is being taken from public, and what public expects by giving such money to the company is interest. So, such persons who have taken up the debentures are known as debenture holders. So, we can say debenture is a document which is issued under the common seal of the company. As we know that company is an artificial person created by law, having its own seals and perpetual existence. So, the company seal is a relevant aspect where any document or agreement is being made for a legal aspect. So, when we issue the debentures, they are too issued at a common seal of the company. So, moving ahead, again we are elaborating the meaning of debenture in a different way. Here it is a acknowledgement of loan received by the company equal to the nominal value of the debenture. It bears the date of redemption and rate and mode of interest. Debenture holder is the creditor of the company. So, again we highlight on certain parameters, that is, it's the acknowledgement of loan. Again, it will be having nominal value, that means the smallest unit at which it is being issued to the public. It bears date of redemption. They are not irredeemable or forever a loan to the company. They are going to be redeemed after the expiry of the redemption period, which is being mentioned on the debenture certificate. Rate of debentures interest is also being mentioned, and the mode of payment of interest, that is quarterly or half yearly or annually, we are going to pay the interest. It too shall be written on the document which is named as debenture under the common seal of the company. And the debenture holder is the creditor of the company, because he is asking the money back from the company which it has given for the purpose of the finance to the company. As per section 2 subsection 12 of the Companies Act 1956, debenture include debenture stock, bond, and any other securities of the company, whether constituting a charge on the company's assets or not. So this is a legal definition which is given under Companies Act. Now, having learned about the meaning of the debentures, now we are going to discuss about various types of debentures. Debentures are being classified under various categories on certain assumptions or certain bases. The first one is on the basis of security, then on the basis of redemption, on the basis of records, on the basis of convertibility, and lastly on the basis of priority. Again, subclassification is being made. When we talk about debentures on the basis of security, they are being classified as secured debentures or mortgage debentures, and another category is that of unsecured debentures. Secured or mortgage debentures are further being classified as first mortgage and second mortgage. So, under security, we have two level of divisions. When we talk about debentures on the basis of redemption, they are of two types, redeemable and non-convertible or irredeemable. On the basis of records, we have registered debentures and bearer debentures. When we talk about convertibility, it is on account of convertible debentures or non-convertible debentures. There are only two categories. And on the basis of priority, debentures are being classified as first debentures and second debentures. Now we are going to learn about them one by one. What do we mean by each of these categories and what's the meaning of various types of debentures which are being classified on these five bases. First one is debentures being classified from security point of view. So, the first category is secured or mortgage debentures. These are the debentures that are secured by a charge on the assets of the company. These are called mortgage debentures. The holder of the secured debentures have the right to recover the principal amount with the unpaid amount of interest on such debentures out of the asset mortgaged by the company. So, here what we are doing is that we are securing the portion of the debentures by the asset. There is an asset backing. When assets are being mortgaged and amount is being realized, the principal amount as well as the unpaid amount of interest on such debentures are being secured. In India, debentures must be secured, and secured debentures are again of two types as we have discussed in our diagram, that is first mortgage debentures. By first mortgage debenture, we mean that the holder of such debentures have a first claim on the assets charged. And when we talk about second mortgage debentures, the holders of such debentures have a second claim on the assets charged. So, the priority basis is being set under the mortgage debentures or secured debentures which are being secured by asset backing. So, firstly, the first mortgage debentures would be paid off as they have charged on such assets, and then the second mortgage debentures. Now, its second category is of unsecured debentures. Debentures which do not carry any security with respect to the principal amount or unpaid interest are called unsecured debentures. They are the simple debentures. So, their principal amount as well as the unpaid interest amount is totally unsecured. There is no asset mortgage being taken place for repaying the amount of the money due to such debenture holders. Now, on the basis of redemption, we have to learn the two types of debentures, that is redeemable and non-redeemable. First, when we talk about redeemable debentures, these are the debentures which are issued for a fixed period. This period can be 5 years, 10 years, depending upon the deed so drafted. The principal amount of such debenture is paid off to the debenture holders on the expiry of such period. These can be redeemed by annual drawings or by purchasing from open market. So, emission of the debentures will take place. There are various methods, and among them here we are talking about annual drawing method and purchasing from open market method. So these are the two peculiar methods which we are going to learn in detail when we will learn about the redemption of debentures. Here under redemption of debentures which are redeemable, there is one or two points which we need to keep in mind is that it is for fixed period, but the principal amount would be paid only after the expiry of that period of redemption. That means after the gestation period being over, they are being paid off. However, interest will be paid regularly. It can be annually or half yearly, whatever has been the scheme of the debentures under which they are being issued to the public. Non-redeemable debentures. These are the debentures which are not redeemed in the lifetime of the company. Such debentures are paid back only when the company goes into liquidation. Liquidation means winding up of the company has taken place. On the basis of the records. On the basis of records, first of all, we are discussing about registered debentures. These are the debentures that are registered with the company. The amount of such debenture is payable only to those debenture holders whose names appear in the register of the company. There are set of registers which are being prepared for doing the compliance under various provisions of Companies Act, and out of such compliance, register of debenture holder is also being maintained by the company. And when such register is being maintained and name of the holders are being written in such register, at the time of the payment of the money of such debentures, only that person would be given the money whose name is recorded with the company. Now, it's another category is bearer debenture. These are the debentures which are not recorded in a register of the company. Such debentures are transferable merely by delivery. Holder of this debenture is entitled to get interest. However, principal amount would be paid whosoever is having the debentures in hand, because such debentures are bearer debentures. Now, the next category of the debentures are on the basis of convertibility. Among it, the first one is convertible debentures. These are the debentures that can be converted into shares of the company on the expiry of pre-decided period. The term and condition of conversion are generally announced at the time of issue of debentures. And the second one are non-convertible debentures. The debenture holders of such debentures cannot convert their debentures into shares of the company. Convertible and non-convertible debentures are self-explanatory. On the basis of priority, first debentures, these debentures are redeemed before other debentures. They are preferential in their payments. The next category is on the basis of priority, and on the basis of priority, again a segregation is made on the basis of first debentures and second debentures. First debentures are those preferential debentures which are redeemed before other debentures. That means they have a priority in the payment of their money. Second debentures, these debentures are redeemed after the redemption of first debentures. That is, their priority is second in comparison to the first debentures. Still, they are the debentures on the basis of priority as far as their payments are being concerned. Now, the next topic which we are going to learn in detail is issue of debentures. We are well versed now with the meaning of debentures, that is the loan capital and various types of debentures. Now, we are moving towards issue of debenture. We are going to learn its accounting entries to be passed in the books of the accounts of the company. By issue of debentures, we mean that issue of a certificate by the company under the seal, which is an acknowledgement of the debt taken by a company. So, where a debenture is being issued, it's a certificate which says that company has acknowledged that debt which it has taken from the public. The procedure of issue of debenture by a company is similar to that of shares. A prospectus is issued, applications are invited, and letter of allotment are issued. On rejection of application, application money is refunded. In case of partial allotment, excess application money may be adjusted towards subsequent call. So, here the mechanism is same as that of issuing of the shares, that we have to issue a prospectus, applications are being invited, and letter of allotments are being issued. Then applications can be rejected and application money is to be refunded. The same mechanism as we have learned in the case of the issue of shares are to be followed when we issue the debentures. Issue of debentures takes various forms which are as under: debentures issued for cash, debentures issued for consideration other than cash, debentures issued as collateral securities. So, these are the three conditions or forms under which debentures can be issued. They can be issued for cash. That means we are receiving cash when we issue the debentures. They can be issued for consideration other than cash. That means where we have to make payment, but we are not paying the consideration or not receiving the consideration in cash, debentures can be a mode for the payments, or as a collateral security, they can be given. Further, debentures may be issued at par, premium or discount, and these conditions can be used in all these three categories where debentures are being issued at cash. They can be issued either at premium, at par or discount. When we have issued them for consideration other than cash, then also these three types of issues can be made. So, they are the broad conditions and these are the ways in which the debentures can be made. Now, let us understand the accounting treatment of issue of debentures. Accounting treatment of issue of debentures for cash. This is the first situation we are taking up. Here, debentures issued for cash at par. That means equal to the nominal value or face value of the debentures. We are issuing such debentures to the public. Following general entries will be made. Application money is received. So, the entry will be bank account debit to debenture application account debit, application money received for debentures. Now, when allotment is being made due, such application money will be transferred. So, transfer of debenture application to debenture account on their allotment. So, debenture application account will be debited to debentures account. That means application money transferred to the debenture account on allotment. Because whatever money we have received on account of applications being received, they will be the part of debentures only when allotment of the debentures are being made. It is similar to the issue of shares. Third one is money due on allotment. So, the entry for making the allotment due would be passed and it is debenture allotment account debit to debenture account being allotment money due. Money due on allotment when received, we are going to pass the entry bank account debit to debenture allotment account and narration is receipt of debenture allotment money. First and final call is made. So, this is a due entry form making the final and first calls due. Debenture first and final call account debit to debenture account and narration would be first and final call money made due on. Here we are going to write the respective number of debentures or the amount of debentures. Debenture first and final call money when received, then we are going to pass the entry bank account debit to debenture first and final call and receipt of the amount due on calls. Here note, two calls, that is first and second call, may be made and general entry will be made on the lines made for first and final call. Now, let us take up an illustration to understand these entries with practical example. Shanning Limited issued 5008% debentures of 100 each, payable as rupees 20 on application, 30 on allotment and 50 on first and final call. So, first of all, we can say that the debentures are issued at par because the par value or the face value is 100 rupees and application, allotment and first calls money per share, when we add them, it is 100 rupees. All these debentures were applied for and allotted and the calls were duly received. Make necessary journal entries in the books of the company. Now, moving towards solution, first of all, we can make our workings or rough calculations. Here, first of all, the entry which we are going to pass for receiving the application money would be for 1 lakh rupees, that is 5000 debentures into rupees 20 for application. Then, when allotment money is received, we are going to pass the entry as 5,000 into 30, that is 1,50,000 entry would be passed, and for calls it will be for 2,50,000, both at the time of making the calls and allotment due and receiving the money thereon. So let us move towards the journal where we are going to pass these entries. So this is a journal of Shining India Limited. First of all, we have passed the entry as bank account debit to debenture application for 1,00,000 rupees, application money received for 5,000 debentures. Next entry is when the allotment is made due. So when allotment is made, at that time the application money is transferred to the debenture account. So debenture application account debit to 8% debentures. Here 8% is the rate of interest associated with the debentures. So 1,00,000 entry is being transferred to the debenture account, and the narration is application money transferred to debenture account on allotment. Now we have to make the allotment due. Debenture allotment account debit to 8% debentures for 1,50,000, being allotment due on 5,000 debentures at 30 rupees per debenture. So it amounts to 1,50,000. Next entry is when we have received the money on the allotment due. It is bank account debit to debenture allotment, 1,50,000, being allotment money received. And now the entry would be for first and final call to be made due, and then we will receive the money thereon. So the next entry is debenture first and final call account debit 2,50,000 to 8% debentures 2,50,000, debenture first and final call made at rupees 50 per debenture, and money is received on such first and final call, and we have passed the entry as bank account debit to debenture first and final call for rupees 2,50,000, and we have narrated it as receipt of debentures first and final call money. Now we are concluding up our discussion of today based on the loan capital, that is debenture, its meaning, and various types of debentures which are being issued by the company to the public for raising the funds. Today we have also learned about the issue of debentures for cash at par, and its accounting entries are being discussed, and a practical example is being taken up to understand how the calculations will flow and how the accounting would be done for issue of the debentures in the books of the company. With this, we are ending up our today's discussion based on the issue of debenture. Thank you.